I got a chance to talk with my doctor today. And I'd gotten a vaccine that covers 23 different varieties of pneumonia. But the type that I had gotten had to do with my stomach. I don't know how to explain it, but, you know, go figure. The one type that I wasn't covered for was a vaccine. That's what I got. It's crazy. But antibiotics are working, the pain's going away. I can lay down now. When I go to bed at night and not feel like I had an elephant sitting on my chest.
When a thief stole her mother's SUV, Good Day's Emily Ikeda joins us now with the latest from investigators. Emily, good morning.
Good morning. Well, I told you earlier, DeKalb County Police taking an all-hands-on-deck approach, and this is what I mean. You can see more than 10 DeKalb County police cars conjugating in this shopping center. We're just a few minutes from where this all panned out on Harvestdale Court in DeKalb County near the Stone Mountain area. Police say that while a food delivery driver was making a drop-off, that person was carjacked. Now, in the 2010 Nissan Armada was one-year-old Royalty Grizzly. So that carjacking then turned into a kidnapping, and you probably got that alarm earlier this morning, an Amber Alert notifying people to be on the lookout for a maroon 2010 Nissan Armada with a Mississippi license plate. Certainly a frantic, urgent situation, that one-year-old now missing for going on about 6 hours. We're trying to get the latest and an update from DeKalb County Police. We will bring you any information as we learn it. But of course, if you see that Nissan Armada, you are asked to contact 911. Reporting live in DeKalb County, I'm Emily Ikeda for Good Day Atlanta.
All right, Emily.
That is unknown. We don't think so, but that's unconfirmed right now.
But there was a car seat initially?
Yeah.
Or a crime of opportunity?
That, we're still investigating that. I don't have an answer for that just yet.
Maybe the same question. Do you think it's just fine?
We don't think they knew the child was in the car at the time they took it.
Where do you go from here?
Well, our main priority is finding the Miss Grisby, Royalty Grisby. That's our only goal right now, is to make sure we bring her home safe to her mother.
A search on foot? How do you go about that?
Vehicle, foot, using some other assets as well, help from others, state and federal partners to help find her.
How far was the, from where she was taken to where you found the vehicle? How far?
Probably less than a mile, or right about a mile.
So do you think it happened fairly quickly?
The taking of the vehicle?
Yes.
I'm pretty sure it was in with seconds.
No, I mean, the vehicle.
Don't know. That's what we're trying to find out now.
Can you speak to the urgency of this situation?
I mean, it's the utmost urgency. We have a one-year-old child out there that's not with her mother. We fear for her well-being. We want her to be safe, and we want her back home with her mother. Every second that goes by is critical. So everyone who has eyes lives in the neighborhood, on social media, Facebook, whatever, be on the lookout. I believe the picture's out there for the Amber Alert. So we want to get her home to her mother.
Do you guys worry that they could steal another car and you don't have the description of that car?
I mean, that's always a concern, but we're going to make every effort to track that information down, confirm any leads we have, and bring these individuals into custody.
So you don't have any evidence that they got it from you?
No, not at this time.
And your message to the suspects if the child is still in their hands?
Turn them over. Turn her over. That's all. All we want is you to get her home to her mother. Do you want to speak to
You can take her to the hospital. You can take her anywhere. Take her to a store. Just bring her home. She didn't do anything. She was just asleep in the back seat. And that's it.
I know this is difficult. Do you remember anything that happened when they got the car? Can you walk us through what happened?
I got an order for DoorDash, and I picked up the order from Checkers, and then I came to drop it off. And as soon as I went to put the food down, I just heard somebody running, and then I heard the door close. And as soon as I turned around, my truck was, it was going down the street, and my baby was still in the car.
Do you frequently work in this area? Did you ever have a time when something like this happened?
No. I always work in this area. I always work at night because she sleep, and it's easier for me to work when she sleep. And I never go past Lilburn or Ember Hills because it's close to my house. So I do it all the time, and I never thought I was in a residential neighborhood, and it was a nice neighborhood, so I figured nothing would happen there. So I had my keys in my pocket. And the only reason I didn't lock the door is because I was in a residential neighborhood, a nice neighborhood. And I didn't think it would happen, anything like that would happen.
So the vehicle wasn't running?
It was running. But I have the keys. It's a keyless start.
What do you want to say to the man that took your daughter?
I just want my baby home. I don't even care. I don't care about nothing.
We are a republic that uses the right to vote, the democratic process, to elect our leaders. And when you restrict access to that process, you are restricting the citizens of our nation from participating in the future of our country. That is unfathomable to me.
For our Vote Action, Stacey Abrams, founder of the National Organization for Voting Rights, blasts what she calls anti-voting legislation introduced by GOP legislators who, she says, did not like the outcome of last year's election and are now seeking to restrict access to the right to vote.
Restrictions being put in place on absentee balloting are intended to target voters of color who used it in a disproportionate number compared to previous elections, but 450,000 Republicans also use that same mechanism. And so with every single result that they seek, while they may be targeting communities of color and young people, they're going to capture their own voters. And that means it is bad for democracy writ large.
Supporters of the legislature are voter suppression bills. NewsHead reporter Brian Hill was there today as the groups protested outside the World of Coca-Cola downtown. Dozens of people took part in a die-in here behind me, urging corporations like UPS, Coca-Cola, and Home Depot to denounce any legislation that will make it harder for Georgians to vote, especially minority and lower-income communities.
No voter suppression! No voter suppression!
They said that they support us. That doesn't mean anything unless you cut the money off.
Voting impacts every aspect of our life.
The New Georgia Project Action Fund is among the organizers to claim that Coca-Cola has donated more than $30,000 to politicians co-sponsoring voter suppression bills while proclaiming to be allies to the movement.
Putting up a nice Black Lives Matter sign or billboard, that's really cute. But right now is when we actually need you.
There are several bills the group says would greatly impact ballot access for voters.
Yeah, I hate to break it to Stacey Abrams, but in a little fair fight group, there isn't one thing you would do in life without an identification. You can't cash a check. You can't open a bank account. There isn't anything you can do. You can't rent a place to live. You can't drive an automobile without an operator's permit. I don't know what her problem is about people having to prove who they are to get a mail-in ballot. So, wake up, Stacey. All your whining isn't worth squat. And it's all BS. There ain't no voter suppression. We just want to have an honest election. Now, you even have to have an identification to get the vaccine. So, I don't know what Stacey Abrams is complaining about. You don't have an ID, you can't get vaccinated. You need an ID to get vaccinated. What is all the complaining about?
So we continue the smart reopening, right? The graphic that nobody likes.
It's a late show.
Control says they are apprehending on average 500 migrant children a week at the southern border, and many detention facilities are well over capacity. According to Customs and Border Protection, the number of unaccompanied minors at the southwest border has almost doubled from January to February. But Democrats say the spike is due to the last administration.
This is a humanitarian challenge to all of us. What the administration has inherited is a broken system at the border.
Now for the next 90 days, FEMA is stepping in. They will help the government effort to safely receive, shelter, and transfer unaccompanied children at the southwest border. Homeland Security Secretary Alejandro Mayorkas said, quote, our goal is to ensure that unaccompanied children are transferred to HHS as quickly as possible, consistent with legal requirements and in the best interest of the children. A group of Republicans say they want to see the situation for themselves.
We really want to see what's happening, how many unaccompanied minors are coming across.
It's also to highlight what they call hypocrisy from D.C.
Nancy Pelosi and the liberal Democrats hide behind their wall around the Capitol in Washington, D.C.
And they blame President Biden for rolling back many of former President Trump's immigration measures on day one in office.
The Biden border crisis, though, was created by Joe Biden's promises of amnesty and open borders and free health care for illegals during the campaign.
The administration so far during the pandemic has continued to turn away or detain and return adult migrants to Mexico. They are urging people to not try to cross the border. In Washington, Lauren Blanchard, Fox News.
Situation on the ground up close, and they say to report back with possible solutions.
We will work together across the aisle within our own party, because we know the solutions that it will take.
The U.S. Department of Homeland Security asked for FEMA's help over the weekend. That agency, normally tasked with assisting Americans during disasters, will now help, quote, safely receive, shelter, and transfer.
I've made several trips to the border, but today we are seeing a crisis.
Local leaders say any help.
Of course, we're dealing with a global pandemic. And the idea that how do we manage this global pandemic?
Minors may only remain in federal custody for no more than 3 days, and officials say with the extreme backlog, thousands are waiting much longer than that. That's the latest from McAllen, Texas. Casey Stiegel, Fox News.
Our town, our city, our community.
Biden was asked about the surge during an interview with ABC News.
The idea that Joe Biden said come, because I heard the other day that they're coming because they know I'm a nice guy and I won't
give a Trump. They're saying this.
Yeah. Well, here's the deal. They're not.
But they are. Some of them are saying that they expect more lenient treatment from the Biden administration. And the president's secretary of Homeland Security says we are on pace to encounter more individuals on the southwest border than we have in the last 20 years. In fact, U.S. Customs and Border Protection told Congress that since October, four people whose names appear on the FBI terror watch list have been apprehended at the border. A former President Trump, who made border security a signature and controversial issue, lashed out.
I mean, what you're seeing now is very bad record numbers, but it's going to get much, much worse. With a little bit of time, you'll see those numbers expand at a level like you've never seen before.
And we are about to hear much more.
To grab those checks and leave you with absolutely nothing. The answer, yes, but only in some situations and not all of them. Here's John Shirik.
Debt collectors are coming for your stimulus checks if you have old unpaid bills. Question from a viewer. I have old credit card debt plus old unpaid medical bills. Will the creditors seize my stimulus check? Answer, maybe. If the creditors already have a court order placing a claim or freeze on your bank account.
Yes, debt collectors can, in fact, if they have a court order, can, try to tap into the money through the bank account.
Yeah.
Okay.
Republicans are sounding the alarm that all this spending is causing inflation.
Housing prices have skyrocketed around this country. So when they act like, oh, there's no inflation, I mean, it makes no sense because it's happening. And it's not the rich that get hurt with inflation. It's the poor.
The Biden administration is also reportedly considering a tax increase on people in certain brackets to pay for these initiatives. Bray Bogan, Fox 5 News.
Robert Aaron Long, who police say was arrested in South Georgia.
The crime scene stretching across two metro counties. Four victims died at Gold Spa and Aromatherapy Spa in Buckhead. The four others were killed at Young's Asian Massage in Acworth.
We have team coverage as this story unfolds tonight. And we start with CBS 46's Sierra Cummings live in Acworth. Sierra, what are you learning about the suspect?
That suspect, Robert Long, was arrested within the last couple of hours. Now, take a look. Cherokee County Sheriff's Office still out here and will be all throughout the night combing for clues. Now, this is a town that went from one murder last year to now four killings all in one day. The suspect then leaving here in Acworth to then go wreak havoc in Atlanta. Nearly 4 hours after the horror at this massage parlor and two more in Atlanta, a 21-year-old suspect found and arrested in Crisp County.
They did a pit maneuver on him and took him into custody, as far as I know, without incident.
The motive is still unclear, but police say Robert Aaron Long walked in and out of massage parlors today within minutes, changing eight lives and two communities forever here in Acworth and Atlanta.
We never know when we're at the wrong place at the wrong time because this was so all of a sudden, and it was just like a lot of things racing through my head.
Her uncle
telling all the family to pray for him.
Now the sole survivor of the Cherokee County massage parlor shooting.
I think it's the store beside it, probably buying a few items before heading home. He had just gotten off work.
Two others died on scene here. Two more died in an area hospital. Detectives have not confirmed if this is a hate crime, but they say based on evidence, Long is the same suspect in all the homicides.
It appears that massage parlors potentially being targeted.
The fatal victims today were Asian and white. It's still unclear how many were customers versus workers, but as dozens stood watching the heartbreaking scene unfold with more questions than answers, detectives said they plan to get justice for these communities.
Well, nothing's going to be ruled out. We're conducting a multiple homicide investigation. So wherever the evidence leads us, that's where the investigators will go.